All right, definitely keeping this. All right, so it looks like he's black white. And got full value. Put a card on the bottom. All right, come on, Psychic Intrusion, be sweet. Omen Speaker, Scry. Those are both good. But I don't think I want either. I just want to draw lands, so. I mean, as good as both these cards are, I'm just going to actually put both on the bottom. We have a 5-drop and a 6-drop. We have plenty of things to do when we draw lands, so. Like, we already have a 3-drop here, a 4-drop, 5-drop, and 6-drop. So when he attacks, this guy's gonna gain flying, so no point holding back the Omen Speaker. Might as well attack. And play a Minotaur. Our hand is pretty juicy. Okay, that's also a human, which is annoying. Yeah, so I'm just gonna attack again. No blocks. Snuck through a point of damage. Yeah, I'm gonna actually. I want a Griptide end of turn. Just gives me a little more play here. I'm gonna take some extra damage this turn, but like this allows us to play around. Like if I just tap out on my turn, then he might just like put some kind of big enchant creature on the Phalanx leader. That is a giant. Let's put this on top. Well, had I known I was going to draw this, I would have put this on top. This Cavalry Pegasus is actually pretty annoying. Actually, bouncing this is not the worst, because by bouncing it, he has a choice of whether or not he wants to play the 3/5 or the Pegasus. If he plays the 3/5, he can't even attack us. But let's see. Like I can attack for 2 here, and if I bounce this, he can't attack me back. And if I like, so I can like Voyages into Pegasus and play a Guardians. Or do I just take 4 for another turn? Or I can just cast Psychic Intrusion, but this is a little risky because he hasn't missed a land drop. So like that last card in his hand could just be a land, and then this would be terrible. So it's better for me to Voyages end something and then cast it after casting the Psychic Intrusion. Yeah, Like, so if I attack with both, bounce this, then he's going to attack with both, and I just take one. Three for one, but do I want to trade this one damage? Actually, yeah. I'm just going to attack. Maybe I want the Harpy because of this thing. I don't know. This guy seems to block a lot if he doesn't have the stupid Pegasus. So yeah, I think I'm gonna bounce end step. Yep. Question is, what do I want to bounce? Think I want to bounce a Pegasus because then it's really hard for him to attack. But it's really hard for me to attack. I guess this is a human. Yeah, I'll bounce the Pegasus. I'm going to put that on the bottom. Because we just want to draw a swamp. I don't want a double black card. Whew, that was a good one. I guess we can use the Lash of the Whip to kill the Silent Artisan and get it back, or I can just intrusion him now because this doesn't do anything. And I'm just going to intrusion him now. Alright, so he did have a land. So yeah, casting it the turn before would have been really bad. Yeah. So now he can't attack us. That's fine. Unless he finds a way to pump this, maybe. No, because then we can still double block the Philosopher. All right. Awkward mana is awkward mana. Yeah, I'm just going to play this. Oh, wait, I thought I can cast. How does this work? Wait. Let me see. You may cast that card for as long as, and you may spend mana as though it were mana of any color to cast that spell. Hold on. I gotta figure out this bug. Okay. I will figure this out. No. How do I cast this thing? It says you can cast that card for as long as it remains exiled, and you may spend mana as though it were mana of any color. So I should be able to cast this for free, right? Or I should be able to cast it for 2 mana. Oops. All right. So I asked around. I asked like Paul Reitzel and some others, and they were just like, just click around a bunch of random stuff before. But you definitely click the spell before putting mana in pool. Then it gets hard. Boom. Okay. All right. Apparently, okay. That was hard. Okay. My kingdom for a swamp. Whoa. Lash of the Whip deals with that very nicely. Ooh, that was also nice, but my plays do not change. I'm just gonna kill that and attack with my two flyers. And these guys hold the fort very well. This guy can block the 3/5, and this guy can block either one of the other two creatures. I guess this disciple combos with Voyage's End as well. If I do draw the second copy, although it is on the bottom of my deck, or Mnemonic Wall, I suppose. Ooh, that was filthy. All right. All right. Well, he can't attack me still, so we're still kind of winning, but he's like a top tick away from kind of blowing me out, I guess. I'll try to play a little faster. So I'm actually going to play the disciple because it is a human. He's gonna go down to 9 life this turn, and then by playing this, it's a 3-turn clock, to go with the Pegasus. He went straight into his attacker's phase, so this could be a little scary here. Nope. First game mana screw, now mana flood. Is that a human? I put that one on the bottom. I have enough walls at this point. I'll take a random draw over a 2/3. So if he doesn't kill the Pegasus this turn, we should be looking really good, because now we have four flyers. Look at this Pegasus doing work. All these random blue-black human. All right. We managed to figure out how to cast that thing. On to the next round.